return of the plant. This was sort of a novel idea for its day in 1913. Prior to this, the car chassis were assembled in various bays, and the parts actually came to the car. What Mr. Ford and his team decided to do was try to experiment with what we know today as the limited assembly line, starting with a chassis like this and sliding it the length of the plant with all the sub-assemblies coming in from the side. Far more efficient, and they were able to drop the assembly time down to a much shorter interval. When they started building these cars in 1908, they were hand-assembled in about 12 hours. Once they got going with the assembly line, they got it into down to about an hour and a half with a complete assembly of a moving car. The rear end is going in. There was 15 in that 19-year period. First 2 years, they were averaging about 15,000 cars per year. Once they got the assembly line going in the mid-teens and up to speed, they were producing almost 100,000. And by the early 1920s, they produced 2.2 million automobiles in one calendar year. It was a staggering amount. They were putting out 9,000 vehicles per day out of one automobile plant. 9,000 vehicles a day. With one rolling off the assembly line every 30 to 90 seconds. The bodies themselves, you see behind us here, there's a number of different body styles. They were all put onto the same frame. A lot of things about the chassis that didn't change from body to body. Each one of the different bodies could be dropped right onto the chassis without any change. The motor is an inline four-cylinder. That block itself was the first block of its type to be flat. Cast in one cast. Prior to that, most of the engines and all the different makes were that the cylinders were cast in pairs or in individual trucks. This is a far more efficient way to manufacture and a far more reliable engine. You'll see the transmission housing with the three pedals on both the back of the planetary today. It's a little bit different than one of the other standard crash box transmissions, standard transmissions of its day. It uses a set of bands inside to go through the way they're just tightening up the rear shackles. And you can see it's an ETA approved bumper that's mounting there. There was, you have to imagine, folks, that back in the day, these automobiles were driven on some very, very rough roads. The very best roads they had were the equivalent to the very worst gravel roads that we travel today. There wasn't that many paved roads around. So, the other thing that was unique about this is that most of the people that bought these automobiles, this was the very first car that they ever rode. They were literally driving up to the dealership with a horse and buggy and leaving with a new car. The car started off in 1908, the first car was $850. As time went on and they became more efficient, Mr. Ford and his company was able to drop the price so that by the middle 1920s, they could buy a $4 car of around $220. He was absolutely obsessed with cost control, to the point where he owned the entire supply chain up and down for the vehicle. He owned the steel mills, he owned the railroads, he bought traction lumber, the organization to supply the wood for these vehicles. Everything associated with the production of the car, the Ford Motor Company owned. The only thing that Ford did not produce in the entire production was the rubber. All the tires were Firestone. Firestone and Mr. Ford were very good friends, and they cut a deal early on, and Firestone was the only other manufacturer. We're going to put Ford's ears and Quaker State in there, and there we go. How are we doing for time?
4:12.
Okay, another 2 minutes. They were very, very popular. Probably a lot of our grandparents were used to them. The color, as you know, later in the year, the first few years there were different colors. They started off red, and then there were some blues and grays in there.
But
by 1915, they had to come up with a standard color, just so that they didn't have to do a lot of changes car by car. And the color they settled on was black. A lot of the urban myth is black because it's dried the quickest. It's probably not true. What we really think is we don't really have anything to go off on other than the fact that the black color is the front needs to produce. A couple of cranks on the front, we'll see what we're doing here.
Spinning, so
sometimes these things can be a little difficult. actually had an office in Richmond, and you can see the seat on it a minute ago. The pedal on your left is your clutch, your high and low gear. The pedal in the middle is your reverse. The pedal on the right is your brake. The handbrake on the upside is really just an emergency brake. So, 10-gallon gas tank, Robert's sitting down there. Grabbing the seat, let's go through the pump.
I think it took. He knows how to delete.